Hi, I'm Dr. Jeremy Neal. I'm a professor of philosophy at Houston Baptist University. I want to talk today about St. Augustine, and especially the debate between free will and determinism. I interpret Augustine, and in this I'm following some mainstream Augustine interpreters, as being a compatibilist on the free will issue. By that is meant that Augustine believes that it is possible for God's determining power to be compatible with our free will. So Augustine believes that we do have free will in a full and complete sense, while God's sovereignty is also paramount and God's determining power is also legitimate. So the issue of free will can be seen as divided into three different potential views. This is just one way of thinking about it. We have as one possible view, at least in terms of theological free will, the determinist view, which might hold that God, an omnipotent and omniscient creator, determines what happens in the universe, including especially human behavior. On the determinist view, then, any free will that human beings might have would certainly not be free will in the sense that you or I typically understand it. Most determinists, especially hard determinists, don't think that we have free will at all. Then there's the compatibilist position, which I'll explain in a minute, but on the other side, we might have a libertarian position on free will, which might hold that human beings have free will and that God's sovereign power does not exercise any determining influence on the choices that they make. The libertarian free will position is certainly the position that syncs up most readily with my felt experience, and probably yours as well, although that doesn't necessarily make it the correct position on the free will debate. In the middle, we might think of the compatibilist position as being located. So I interpret St. Augustine to be a compatibilist, and by that is meant, as mentioned, that free will is compatible with God's determining power. Now, a major problem for compatibilists is explaining the mechanism for how it is possible for human beings to choose freely and for God to determine simultaneously. Different metaphors could be used. One metaphor that I like to employ sometimes is to think of a soldier on a battlefield. This metaphor has its limitations, so bear with me up through the metaphor and then we can discard those limitations. But the soldier on the battlefield who is ordered by a general into battle has free will. He can choose not to go into battle. At the same time, his general has a certain determining influence on his behavior. In that sense, the general's actions and the soldier's actions are both simultaneously influencing the fact that the soldier is entering into battle. When I was a little kid, I frequently didn't want to clean up my room. And sometimes my mother would tell me to clean up my room. Maybe we were having company coming over that night. She would say, clean up your room, and so I would do it. Now, several hours later, my room would be clean. And the issue arises, what caused my room to be clean? Which agent, my mother or myself, caused my room to be clean? Well, in a certain sense, we both did. In a certain sense, I caused my room to be clean because I did the actual cleaning of the room, and without me, it would not have been cleaned. But in a certain sense, also, my mother caused the room to be clean. Even though she didn't do the actual cleaning of the room, she's the one who compelled me to clean the room. And so in a certain sense, without her, the room would not have been cleaned either. At any rate, metaphors like the general and soldier metaphor or the room cleaning metaphor do break down at a certain point because they don't necessarily sync up with our felt experience. But it is with metaphors of such a kind that compatibilists often seek to defend their position about the free will issue.